Hey. Brought Miss Barrett up a few minutes ago. Okay. She's in for the night.
Good.
All right. Well, then, see you tomorrow.
Okay.
Freak me out.
I was just...
You know what? I'm gonna call a concierge.
No, I'm fine.
Okay, well, can we at least move you over to the couch?
Yeah, I was just gonna get some water and all right.
Well, why don't you just take it easy?
I'm okay.
Just sit down, relax. I'll get the water for you, okay?
This photo shoot really early and I didn't get any sleep. That's all it is. I get really nervous and nauseous when I have to do photo shoots. And I just haven't.
You probably dehydrated. Just take small sips.
Thanks.
Is there anything else I can get you? You want a cheeseburger or something like that? There's a great Italian restaurant down the street on 64th. My cousin works there. They don't normally deliver, but I'm sure I could call in and favor, and I'm sure they do something special for you.
That's okay. I'll just order some room service. I think I just need to sleep.
Right. So. Okay. I will be out in the hall. You know what, Miss Barrett, I don't mean to overstep any boundaries here or anything, but you just passed out. I'm gonna feel like a real idiot if I sit out there knowing you're here.
Oh, no.
Alone. Can I call someone?
Not really, no.
Friends? Family?
No. I'm fine. Look. Would you mind staying in here with me while I sleep? I mean, if you could just stay in here and talk. I can't fall asleep unless I hear somebody talking.
On one condition. You let me call my cousin, have him bring over some real food, some of which you actually eat.
Okay. That's a deal. Hey. I'm gonna go out on a limb and assume you're not having a great day.
How did you guess?
To those who love you, you're an open book.
You think so?
You have the weirdest look on your face. Like you've realized the value of something lost forever.
Well, that's pretty poetic of you, baby. I'm sorry to disappoint you, though. I'm not that deep. I'm just working on this case.
How's it going?
Pretty terrible.
And the lack of forward momentum is getting you.
It's scary how well you know me.
Well, I won't use my scary powers of perception against you.
That's good.
That's better.
Well, you know what? You make everything better. How did I get so lucky?
You must have done something, right?
You know, I gotta get back to work.
Well, how about I order some Italian and we have a relaxing night in, watch some bad TV?
You know, that sounds amazing. I think I'm probably gonna be pulling a pretty late night here. Probably shouldn't wait up.
Hey, you got a minute?
Yeah, sure. Make one. It's in there.
All right.
What's up?
So, Claire caught Michael in Sonny's office and she threatened to turn him in for parole violations.
Threatened, meaning she didn't actually do it.
Well, Sonny got Claire to back off, but we can't count on that working indefinitely. Things between them are upside down right now.
Yeah, I can imagine.
So Claire could actually turn on Sonny and use Michael to make that point. I was wondering if you could talk to her and get her to back off.
Sure. Consider it done. I'll also talk to Michael, remind him about the conditions of his parole and that he can't go anywhere that Sonny could conceivably be. In the meantime, I got John Zakara's car bomb investigation thrown on my desk. The Lopez brothers, may they rest in peace or burn in hell, whatever your sentiments may be, have been cleared, making Sonny the prime suspect. So, Michael could be called in as a witness.
Yeah, Michael wasn't there.
Well, Sonny talks to him. I'm letting you know so that maybe you can give him some support.
All right, he'll have it.
Well, well, isn't this interesting? What reason could there possibly be for Sonny's hitman to be in conference with a detective? Oh, that's right. The detective also happens to be Sonny's son. Being in a huddle with Jason Morgan is a perfect example of the questionable behavior that's going to land you in front of an IA board. And after the debacle that was Sonny's trial, the best shot that we have ever had at putting a criminal behind bars, I would love to see you lose your badge.
Yeah, great. You know what? I was just actually questioning Mr. Morgan about the Johnson car bomb.
And I was going to call my lawyer.
Well, I guess I should get her number because it sounds like I'm going to need one myself.
You know, if Mayor Floyd makes that IA investigation happen, I don't think you need a lawyer. I think you just need to talk to Sam and Spinelli because I understand they have pictures of the mayor in bed with the hooker.
What a coincidence. I have damning evidence of the same nature.
Don't push your luck, Falconeri. You won't survive around here without my support.
Yeah, well, I'll take my chances.
Hate that guy.
I was gonna say something because I was gonna ask you. You wouldn't really stick your neck out for
me. No, I'd rather not, but Michael needs you. Mm. And until he doesn't, I guess I'd have to say yes.
Okay, see you later.
Max and Milo just leave us. Does that mean we're alone?
Yeah.
I think we need to talk.
Yeah. We should go. Let's go upstairs. I can't believe you're Sonny's son. I can't believe it.
I didn't know you had a history with Sonny.
Well, that's all it is history now.
You kept the secret?
Yeah, of course. I promised I'd keep the secret, did you?
Never said a word.
So no one knows but us.
It's gotta stay that way.
Yeah.